Replacing words and cutting boo-boos in Audacity. There are three main parts to this video. First, removing stuff from your recording. Second, putting stuff in. And then some cool editing tools. Hello, everybody. This is Phil Chenevert with some simple editing techniques for Audacity, specifically aimed for LibriVox recorders. And every recording we make needs to have things removed, like microphone bumps, dogs barking, burps, and just about as often, words or phrases need to be removed and replaced with the correct word or phrase. So let's start with removing unwanted things from your recording. Very simple technique. Now listen carefully to this snippet from Smoldering Shoulders and see if you can hear what needs to be removed.
Consuela could feel her heart beating faster, and her head became light as Raul picked her up in his arms and started to,
"Hey, Johnny, come to supper!"
And then Raul, startled, gasped, "Where am I?" and dropped her.
Okay, I think it's pretty clear that there are some problems there. Yes, the call to supper is the first thing that needs to be removed. Let's find out where that is.
And her head became light as Raul picked her up in his arms and started to...
Right there. Now, first I put my cursor in front of the offending passage, right there. Click and drag to highlight it, like this. Well, I can't do that, can I? There we go. Notice my cursor's right there. I'm going to highlight that call to supper. Then I'm going to click on the scissors icon, and it is gone. Now, let's listen to that. I'll go back to the beginning, and we'll hear...
Consuela could feel her heart beating faster, and her head became light as Raul picked her up in his arms and started to...
Well, now, I'm going to undo that delete. Edit. I'm going to undo that cut, rather. And there it is, right back again. I'm going to put my cursor in front of it and do it again. Drag it and cut it. Boop, it is now gone. Notice that the edit undo thing is very good. It'll undo almost anything that you do if you make a mistake. Now, there are also several microphone bumps, groans, and various other things that need to be removed. Watch how I do this. I'm going to click... and cut, once I'm using the little scissors. There are many ways to do this, but this is the most obvious. Now, I could have done the whole portion at one time. Now, let's listen to it.
Consuela could feel her heart beating faster, and her head became light as Raul picked her up in his arms and started to... And then Raul, startled, gasped, "Where am I?" and dropped her.
Now you may notice that there was too much silence right in here. Now I'm going to use the same technique, click drag, and I'm going to tell it that I want to remove that section. Boop. That section is gone.
Whoops. Started to, and then Raul, startled, gasped, "Where am I?" and dropped her.
This is how to remove a word or phrase and replace it with the correct one and have it sound like it was right there the whole time. This is an easy one. Listen to this.
Johnny, time for your bath.
Now, the word Johnny should be replaced by Mary. First, I place my cursor in front of the wrong word and click. Okay, then I push record and say, Mary, stop. Now I have two tracks. I'm going to place my cursor in front of Mary, which I just recorded. Go to Edit, Copy. Then go up to the first section, where my cursor is down here. You can't see it very well, right here. Click, Edit, and Paste. Now, and then I'm going to, very importantly, I'm going to delete this track I just made.
Mary, Johnny, time for your bath.
So now I have the right word, Mary, and the wrong word, Johnny. So I'm going to click in front of Johnny, move it over here. Now at this point, it'd be nice for you to learn about Z, zero crossings. Press the letter Z on my keyboard, which slightly moves that into where it's the smallest possible wave signs. Click the sign here, okay? Now let's listen to my new recording.
Mary, time for your bath.
And that's it, folks. That's the very basic concept of how to remove stuff you don't want and then to replace it with the right stuff. Now, what follows in this little video is going to be more advanced techniques that deal with more complicated situations. But if you can remove and replace words and phrases, or bumps and snaps and dog barks and things like that, you are 90% to making your recording sound great. But if you want to keep on, just keep on listening. Many times, words run together and are not easily cut like Mary and Johnny was. To make these repairs sound really good, you must master a few of the wonderful tools built into Audacity. Zoom in, zero crossings, the Z, and play cut review, another wonderful tool. Okay, here's an example where room, the word room, is going to be replaced with courtyard.
Raoul saw the two women across the room glaring at each other and knew that soon he must make a decision. Was it to be Consuela, the dark, fiery little temptress? Or the other one, what was her name again?
I'm going to place my cursor in front of the wrong word.
Saw the two women across the room.
It looks like about right there is the word room. Now I'm going to zoom in, plus that, to try to get the lowest possible waveform here. Okay, now let's listen to that.
Room, room.
Yep, that's the wrong word, all right. I'll use the exact same technique, placing my cursor right there, recording courtyard. Courtyard, stop. Once again, you notice you have two tracks now. It automatically opens up a second track for you. I'm going to highlight the word courtyard. I'm going to copy the word courtyard. Go up and, oh dear, where am I going here? Oh, there it is, right there. By putting your cursor there to start with, it'll give you exactly where to put that word. Then I'm going to paste it in. It's there, and remove the track I just made. I'm going to zoom out a little bit.
Across the courtyard, room glaring at...
Aha! Now let's find the word to remove.
Across the courtyard, room...
There it is, right there. Zoom in a little bit. I should be using this. I've changed my keyboard so I can zoom in just pressing a certain letter. It's so much easier. Anyway, I've highlighted what I think is the word room.
Room.
Yes.
Room.
Now I'm going to teach you, or you're going to learn, about the wonderful cut preview. This allows you to listen to your track before and after with that word gone. Let's listen to it. I'm going to press the letter C.
The courtyard glaring at each other.
You notice how it just skipped over that? So now I know that that's about the right spacing. I'll do it again.
The courtyard glaring at each other.
That's perfect. Perfect. If it was wrong, I could adjust these spaces a little bit. Of course, I also want to press Z, which will find the very perfect spots to do the cut. And then I'm going to cut. And go back here.
Courtyard glaring at each other and knew that soon.
All right. So a quick review. We're going to find the word. Whoops. Find the word. Pardon me. Find the word that we want to cut out.
Room. Room.
That's a little bit not quite enough. We'll zoom in to get some good ones there.
Room. Room.
Okay. That's about right. And then we'll record the new word, courtyard, stop it, highlight, copy, paste, remove the menu track,
the courtyard room.
Then take out the word that we want to take out. Highlight it, more or less, press Z to find zero crossings. Listen to what it's going to be like without that word in there.
The courtyard, glaring at each other.
Sounded good to me. And then cut it. At that point, we now have...
Art glaring at each other.
And that basically is what we want to do. You can make your recording sound seamless, replace words, whole phrases, sentences. Many times it's better to replace an entire phrase so that you get the volume and everything just right. Remember that the LibriVox Wiki has lots of information. The LibriVox Forum is full of people who are willing to help you. And please record lots of great books. LibriVox needs you.